पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्त्वाविद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणमिदाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So in 164th avarta, in the fourth chapter, or the Chaturtha Taranga, we saw as Rajju being the Adhishthana for Kalpita Sarpa is Laukika Drishtya, Mandadikari Samadhanartham, Stula Drishtya or Laukika Drishti, where not much inquiry is done. There you say that in the Brahmasthala, Adhishthana for Sarpa is Rajju, whereas Siddhanta is that the Adhishthana is always Chaitanya, it is never Jada. And thereby Tattva Drishti's Prashna was, question that Tattva Drishti has asked is, who is this Drashta that you say, you are the Adhar and Adhishthana, who is a drashta of this prapancha? So if it can be seen both ways, the Adhar and Adhishthana is the drashta, or you who are the drashta is the Adhar and Adhishthana. In either case, who is that drashta has to be understood. Who is that you? And Tattva Drishti took the example and inquired into the example as to Rajju being the Adhishthana for Sarpa, Adhar and Adhishthana for Sarpa, Rajju Anya is the Drashta. So we have to differentiate between Drashta and on one side and Adhar and Adhishthana on the other. Which being the case, in the exemplified Atma, you the Atma is the Drashta of this Prapancha. Because you see it, you cognize it, this was the answer given there. Tattva Drishti asked, then if the Atma is the Adhara and Adhishthana for this Prapancha, then Drashta has to be Adhishthana Adhara Anyaha. Thereby Atmanaha Anyaha Koyam Drashtaha, Koyam Drashta, that is the question. Drashtruka Kim, you put in neuter, Samanya Napunsakam Linga. But then Chaitanya brings in the difference between the example and the exemplified. So Guru said that Rajju is the Adhishthana, where Rajju is the Adhishthana, Laukika Drishtya, he says Jada is the Adhishthana. When Jada is the Adhishthana, the Drashta is different from the Jada Adhara Adhishthana. Whereas in the exemplified, the Chaitanya Atma, Chaitana Atma is the Adhishthana. Therefore, there is no another needed as Drashta. And then he said, Mandhadikari Samadhanartham Stula Drishtya Rajwadikam Sarpadya Adhyasa Adhishthanam Iti Ashritya Etadrusha Shanka Samadhane Krite. Shanka and Samadhana were given, raised, Shanka was raised and Samadhana was given based on the Laukika Drishti, Stula Drishti. In reality, Paramarthatastu Advaita Siddhante Sarpadya Adhyasa Adhishthanam Sakshi Chaitanyam Yo Drashtru Chatadeva. So even in the example, Rajju is not really the Adhishthana. If you take Rajju as the Adhishthana, then you are right that Rajju Anyaha Chetana Drashta. But in Siddhanta, in Rajju, Sarpasthala, Brahmasthala also, the Adhishthana is Sakshi Chaitanya, and therefore Drashta is also the Sakshi Chaitanya. Tasmat Kalpita Sakala Drishyanda Koti Sahasrana Adhishthana Bhuta Atma Eva Drashta. Everywhere Atma is Drashta, as long as Drishya Prapancha is considered as being there. Always goes as a pair, Drashta, as long as there is Drishya. Even in Yoga Shastra, it is said, maybe the second chapter, Drashta Drishi Matra. One sutra has said, Drashta Drishi Matra. There are some acharyas who bring Advaita Tattva even in Yoga Shastra by quoting this sutra. There is no Bheda between the two. As long as there is Bheda, then you have name. Name is really what creates the Bheda. Nasmin Pakshe Sankas Samadhanadikam Prasajyateti Guru Raha. In Siddhanta, Chaitanya is the Adhishthana and Adhara as well as Drashta. There is no Shanka and Samadhana. No, there should be no doubt. That's the idea there. In 165th Avartana, which I don't think we have seen this, Mithya Samsara Nivartane Chha Nochita. So, Samsara Nivritti, Atyantiki Samsara Nivritti is Moksha. Paramananda Prapti is Moksha. But Mithya Samsara, when you say Atyantika Samsara Nivritti there, Mithya Samsara. Samsara is Mithya. Sarasad Bhyam Anirvachaniya Mithya. That kind of Samsara Nivartana Ichha is not Uchita. It is not appropriate, not needed, because Samsara Nivritti, you don't want the false to go away. The false is already not there. It's already gone away. There is Nitya Nivritti of Samsara in Atma from the Paramarthika Drishti. So hold on to the Paramarthika Drishti. This is the Guru Vachana. He Somya. Itham mithya bhutam samsara dukkham bhrantya toi pratibhasati. It is not really there. Samsara is not there. Where from will you get samsara dukkha? It is not there in you. Bhrantya toi pratibhasate. It is only a bhranti to see samsara and samsara dukkha in yourself. You are not afflicted by it because samsara is mithya. Tasman mithya samsara dukkha nivavrutha tava na yujyate sananta pada. Dukkhan Nivritti Ichha, that is the idea there. Mithya Samsara Dukkha Nivritsa Tava Na Yujyate. It is not tenable, it is not appropriate. Tatrayam Drishtantaha, what is the example? Yadi Kaschana Mantrikaha Kasmaichit Purushaya Swamantra Prabhavan Mithya Bhutam Shatrum Pradarshayati. Tadata Chatruvina Shaya Nasa Purusho Yatate Tadvat. So Yadi Kaschana Mantrika, there is somebody who has Siddhis, Mantra Siddhi, is a Mantrika. Kasmaichit Purushaya So Mantra Prabhavat Mithyabhutam Shatrum Pradarshayati. He, through some magical powers, he projects some Shatru who is Mithya, not really there. Magical entity, somebody who is Shatru. Just to, either showcase his skills or to torture the person. Whatever be the reason, if one who has Mantra Siddhi, using his Mantra power, he magically projects some enemy for some person. Kasmeshit Purushaya Pradarshayati, shows him. There is an enemy, look at him. So Mantra Prabhavat. And that Shatru is not real, Mithya Bhutam. Tada tat Shatru Vinashaya Nasa Purushu Yatate. He knows that it is a Mantrika Shakti. There is no real Shatru. So the wise person wouldn't be scared of some Shatru who is Mithya. Tadvat, similarly, Mithya Bhuta Samsara Nivruttaye Tava Ichchana Yujyate. Similarly, being Mithya, this Samsara Dukkha should not scare you, because Samsara is Mithya, Samsara is Mithya, therefore Samsara Dukkha also. Samsara cannot scare you, the Dukkha should not scare you. Tatha, Chauktam Gaudapadaihi Mandukya Upanishad Karikaya. सो भगवान गौड़पादाचार्य कारिकाकार सीरीज इन मांडुक्य कारिका प्रपंचो यदि विद्येत निवर्तेत न संशय माया मात्रमिदन्द्वैतम् अद्वैतम् परमार्थतः. सो देयर इज अ डिस्कशन इन द कारिका ऑफ एंड द भाष्य हाउ विल द संसार गो अवे. इट्स अजातवाद. ही सेज व्हाट संसार शुड गो अवे. संसार इज नॉट जात. संसार इज नॉट बॉर्न. आत्मा इज ऑल्सो नॉट बॉर्न. आत्मा इनफैक्ट वेन यू से जाति फॉर आत्मा जात जन्म फॉर आत्मा इत्यादि देन ओनली संसार डिस्कशन कैन बी देर बिकॉज देर हैज टू बी द्रष्टा. द्रष्टा हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट देर. द्रष्टा इज कंपैरिजन विद दृश्य. ओनली दृश्य इज देर देर विल बी द्रष्टा. द्रष्टा हैज नो मीनिंग. अ सीयर हैज नो मीनिंग अनलेस देर इज समथिंग सीन. सो सीयर इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द सीन. साक्षी ऑल्सो इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द साक्ष्य. नथिंग इज बॉर्न. प्रपंच यदि विद्येत. If prapancha samsara had been there, this jagat had been there, nivartetana samsha, undoubtedly it would go away. But it is not there. Why? Maya matram idam dvaitam. Dvaitam, prapancha, jagat, samsara, all these are synonyms. Maya matram, only a projection of maya. Maya itself transforms as though into this dvaita prapancha. And what is this maya? Anirvachaniya. Neither sat nor asat. So that prapancha is not there. If it is, had it been there, it would go away. Then the pursuit also to take away samsara dukkha for samsara nivritti, samsara atyantika samsara nivritti and thereby dukkha nivritti would be tenable. But what is the reality? Paramarthata advaitam. You who is the existent entity alone is. There is none other. Therefore, advaitam paramarthatah iti. Tatha varaha upanishadi cha uktam. Then he quotes another upanishad in a similar manner, which gives a similar sense. Ajnanam mevana kuto jagatah prasangah jivesha deshika vikalpa kathati dure ekanta nirmala chideka rasa swarupam brahmaiva kevalam aham paripurnamasmi iti. I didn't say it in a tone, but anyway, you get the idea. Kutaha jagatah prasangaha ajnanam eva. Jagatah prasangaha na. Ajnanam eva. Actually, ajnanam eva na. Ajnana is also really not there. Ajnana is mithya. Jagatah prasangaha kutaha. Jagata is born from maya. Ajnana avidya. Ajnana itself is mithya. Therefore, mithya jnanam. Mithya ajnana will go with mithya jnana. So, jagatah prasanga kuta kaimutika nyaya. Where is even the possibility of prapancha being real? Jivesha deshika vikalpa katha. Katha, it's a story. Entire life, you know, we narrate the story, what happened in our life. It is a story. After a certain while, the memory has faded away in such a manner that the reality is not felt. You cannot feel, you know, you feel that everything that has gone by, you know, even the intense pain that you have gone through or the occasion of happiness. But right now, all that is faded away. It is there in the memory, but then it is in the vasana rupa. There is some impression left there, but you cannot gather the intensity of the moment, past moment. It seems like a dream, you know. Oh, did it really happen, you know? In old age, you gather back. Oh, I used to jump, you know, jump from the staircase. Now, even if I think about it, I have pain. So, all that is what? It is all katha. You look back on stories, you know, stories across lives. Sure. Which are there, not real. Similarly, this Jiva, Isha, Ishvara, Deshika, Guru. So therefore, everyone else, Jiva needs Mukti. He prays to Ishvara, who gives Chitta Shuddhi. Then, through blessings, he finds Deshika. Deshika is one who shows the dik, points the direction. Which the Jiva, the Shishya has to walk. So, is a Deshika, is a Guru. जीव ईश एंड देशिक देर इज भेद ऑल दैट इज वॉट विकल्प भेद इज कथा इज नॉट पॉसिबल न कैन प्रिंट डाउन दी न जीवेश देशिक विकल्प कथा अति दूर है कथा इज अति दूर इट इज नॉट रियल ऑल कथा इट इज जस्ट जस्ट अ स्टोरी विच यू कैन गैदर एंड देर इज सम लीला दैट्स वाई इट्स अ लीला एकांत निर्मल चिदेक रस स्वरूपम ब्रह्म एव केवलम अहम परिपूर्णम अस्मि दिस जीव हु इज लिमिटेड इन ऑल वेज वॉन्ट्स टू बी ओमनीपोटेंट ओमनीशियंट ओमनीप्रेजेंट बट लिमिटेड इन ऑल वेज देश काल वस्तु परिच्छेद इज देयर फॉर दिस जीव अज्ञा All faculties are limited. Jnana is limited. Jnana is one question away. Ignorance is one question away. That kind of Jnana he has. However qualified he is. Even with multiple PhDs, one cannot answer all the questions. So Ajna. But limited. This limited entity wanting to be limitless is really what? Paripurna. Paripurna is limitless. Paritah Purna, in all ways, Desha Kala Vastu Taha Paripurnam Asmi, Aham Asmi. And Kevala Brahma, Kaivalya. Kaivalya is there. It is Ekanta Nirmala. All the Mala is of the bodies. Ekanta Chit, Ekarasa Swarupam. Homogeneous entity without any segmentation, so ekam eva dvitiyam advitiyam. Therefore, no bhedas, all the three bhedatrayas are not there. So, swajatiya, vijatiya, and swagata bhedas aren't there. That's why Shruti also says ekam eva advitiyam. Evakara is not needed, but it is there. After saying eka, eva has been added. And then advitiya also on top of it. So, each one negates one particular bheda. You can take any which way. Commentators explain, tikas and bhashya and tika explains, but eka, eva and advitiya, all three put together refute the three types of possibilities of bhedas. So that is the idea. So you aham asmi, when one say, one understands this aham asmi, paripurnam asmi, then this jiva is not different from isha. There is no Isha Jeva Bheda. There is no Jeva Deshika Bheda. There is no Isha Deshika Bheda. In fact, Jeva, when he finds a Deshika, he looks at Deshika as Isha. So, there itself some Bheda, Bheda Drishti has gone away. One sees that reality, understands that reality, then there is no Bheda between any. We have seen the earlier five Bhedas which were introduced. All those five are refuted. And what remains after negating is you yourself who cannot be negated. The negator cannot negate himself. That negator is the Kevala Brahma Paripurna. And thereby samsara is mithya. Thereby samsara nivritti ichha is na uchita. No chita. Mithya samsarasyapi dukkha hetutva tan nivritti upaya prashnaha. Tattva drishti agrees, understands now that I am the reality, prapancha is mithya. But mithya prapancha is causing dukkha, be it mithya, but I am afflicted. Brahma is nirmala, atma is nirmala, but I, the samsari, whoever that entity is, I am feeling that dukkha is real. I can't wish it away. Therefore, mithya samsarasya api. Bhavatu mithya, samsaraha mithya eva bhavatu. Tarhi mithya samsarasyapi dukkha, dukkham yadasti. What about that? Dukkha is there. You are saying samsara is dukkha, samsara is mithya, samsara dukkha is also mithya. I do understand this. However, what do I do about the feeling of dukkha? What should I do to take it away? I should do something, right? I cannot just sit here and say, okay, it is mithya. It doesn't take away my dukkha. What should I do to see through this dukkha as mithya completely? Otherwise, it is just lip service. I keep on doing everything. I have sukha dukha. And then I keep on chanting, there is samsara is mithya. That won't help me. What do I need to do to get this to culmination? This idea which you have sown, this seed which you have sown, I want to take it to conclusion. This is the thinking of tattva drishti. Therefore, dukkha hetutva mithya samsarasya api. It can be hetu for dukkha, be it mithya, mithya dukkha hetutva. Tan nivruttaye that mithya dukkha nivritti upaya prashnaha. That dukkha should go away, which may be mithya, but take it away in a mithya way. But how should I take away that mithya dukkha also? He swamin, jagat tvai mithya eva swapna divat pratibhati. Like the swapna prapancha gata, everything that is there, jagat, that is swapnika. So swapna divat pratibhati. Mithya eva, this jagat appears. Swapnavat mithya. It appears like in swapna, nacha asti tat paramartha sadrupena. However, it is not there in sadrupa. Which kind of a sadrupa? Paramartha sat, which is trikala badita sat. Just like the dream world goes away, dream dukkha also goes away, the nightmare vanishes on waking. Similarly, this prapancha also does not stay. At least it is not there. Prapancha dukkha was not there in the dream. It wasn't there in deep sleep. Even with the worst of the pains, the induced sleep using medicine, and then the person sleeps, and at least till that duration, there is no pain of this samsarika dukkha, waking world. Therefore, it is not sat. Trikala padita sat, it isn't. So, paramartha sat, it isn't. Nacha asti tat, paramartha sadrupena, iti yaduktam tat satyameva. So that Guru Ukti is real. I understand Guru Ukti is understandable. I do understand that. However, tathapi yatha mai mithya rupena va rupantarena va. So he says, you are saying the samsara is mithya. And it appears in me. So be it mithya or any other way. In any manner. In any manner, there is janma maranadi rupa samsaraha. So, tathapi yathamai. Mithya rupena va rupantarena va sa janana maranadi rupa samsara na pratibhaset. Right now, pratibhasate. Now, right now, it is not there in me. Mai nasti, tvai mithya eva. So, tattva drishti's perspective, mai jagat mithya eva. Pratibhasate tu samsara dukkham cha pratibhasate. Now you give me a solution in such a manner that this, be it mithya or satya or whatever, let it not be there, that dukkha. Tathapi mai mithya rupena va rupantarena va sa janana maranadi rupa samsara na pratibhaseta. It shouldn't be there. Tatha upaya krupaya upadishyatam mayam. So you should tell me, O Guru, you should tell me an upaya. Means such, in such a manner that janana maranadi rupa samsara, which is mithya, not really there in me, but it should not even appear. Pratna pratibhasit samsara. Because I am afflicted. That affliction may be mithya, but I don't want this mithya affliction also. How do I take it away? Give me the means. Mithyabhuta samsara nivrutte sadhananveshanam tavayujyata iti bhavaduktam. What have you said? You have taught mithyabhuta samsara nivrutti. For that, tadarthe chaturthi, mithyabhuta samsara nivrutte sadhananveshanam tava. It should be na, I think. There's, na is missing. It should be na. Sadhananveshanam tava na yujyata. It should be, it is, you should not search for a means. You should not inquire into the means to take away samsara, which is mithya. There should be a na, in my opinion. I looked up the misprints. I didn't find, but this statement as it is does not make much sense to me. There should be na. Iti bhavaduktam. Because Guru has not taught him that you search for a means. He has said, do not search for a means that there is no need, because he said it is mithya. For mithya, to take a mithya nivritti, you should not look for a means. Giving that thought up is the means. There is no other means. There is no sadhana particularly to take away mithya samsara. Jnana itself will, there is no activity involved there. There is no karma, upasana ityadi. Iti bhava duktam. Yadyapi satyameva. That's why there should be na here somewhere. Yadyapi satyameva tathapi yasya mithya padartho dukkha hetur bhavati. Even after this jnana, there may be, you know, after you taught me that samsara is mithya bhuta, still, for me or for anyone else, there is dukkha. If the dukkha continues, then dukkha should be dealt with. Yadyapi satyame tathapi yasya, yasya kasya api. Me or someone else, mithya padartha dukkha hetur bhavati. This samsara, which is mithya bhuta, made up of padarthas, samsara itself. Jato vekvachane, we can say samsara. Padartha. Samsara is a pada. What is the artha of that pada? This transmigrate, the world of transmigration. That samsara, padartha, is dukkha etu. Yasya kasya api bhavati, tena, tena purushena sadakena, sa mithya padartha tan nivritti sadhanaihi nivartaniyeva bhavati. So Tattvadrishti is saying, you look from my perspective. I, who am feeling dukkha, cannot be compared with you who are not feeling dukkha. You know that it is mithya. You have taught me the samsara is mithya. However, for you, there is no dukkha. That's why you say, don't, you know, you don't need to do anything for dukkha nivritti. It is not appropriate to wish away this dukkha, because dukkha is not real. But I feel it is real. I am feeling it as real. So you look at it from my perspective, says the Shishya to the Guru. Sa mithya padartha tan nivritti sadhanaihi nivartaniya. How should that mithya padartha be dealt with? How should it be dealt with? Through sadhana alone. Sadhana which will lead to nivritti of that samsara. Samsara here is dukkha. Dukkha rupa samsara. Nivartani eva. Nivartani kartavyataya. Something should be done about it to deal with it. Tathahi kasyachit pratidinam bhayankara dukkha dusvapna pradarshanam. Kasyachit pratidinam bhayankara dusvapna darshanam jayate. So, I think I had mentioned in the earlier part, it's coming up. Or maybe in another part, I don't remember. Tathahi kasyachit pratidinam. So, if you know or if you experience yourself, especially, you know, in childhood, we have, you know, kids are scared to go to sleep. Some of these, you know, many of us, you know, had difficulty to go out in the dark. When you close your eyes, it's darkness. Especially when you're alone as a child, you feel protected by your parents. When they are, you know, just step out and there is a dark room, you feel scared. That is a samsara dukkha. There is something out there which is leading to fear. But then what happens is that even when parents are protecting, there is some prarabdha due for bhaya. What happens? The person gets nightmares. Child. In this example, the child, let's say. The child gets nightmares. Parents are helpless there. Parents can enter the dream and protect the child. What are they going to do? So there has to be a waking world upaya to deal with the dukkha, bhaya rupa dukkha for the child in the swapna. Since they cannot enter and protect him. So what should they do? They should look for a solution whereby the child is scared to go to sleep. He says, I do not want to sleep at all. Samsara nivritti. Why? Because dukkha rupa swapna, dukkha rupa samsara, dukkha nivritti. Atyantiki. He wants complete cessation of dream and dream world. He does not want that kind of nightmare. So you have to have an upaya which will deal with it. So that is the example used here. So they use some kind of a mantra shakti with that, or some puja ityadi, some prayaschita karma. All that is done by the parents so that the child is taken care of in the dream also. Otherwise, you know, the child wakes up screaming. And the, you know, parents have to console that the it is mithya, it is all unreal. It was a dream, but the fear is real. Wakes up screaming. Sometimes he doesn't even wake up. It's very, you know, it's a very difficult time for everyone in the vicinity. Especially for the child, of course, because there is bhaya. But it has to be dealt with. Therefore, the guru as a parent has to give some upaya for the child, the shishya, to deal with this mithya dukkha also. Tatha hi kasyachit pratidinam bhayankara dusvapna darshanam jayate sacha mithya bhutasya api tasya svapnasya nivruttaye japa pada prakshalanadi aneka upaya ananutishtati upayan anutishtati, sorry. So, samasa there. Sacha mithya bhutasya api tasya svapnasya nivruttaye. There has to be something done to deal with this swapna, which is mithyabhuta. Be it mithyabhuta. Mithyabhutasya api swapnasya tasya. Nivruttaye. For the nivrutti, what has to be done? Japa ityadi. Pada prakshalana. So, washing the feet. So, there are some upayas to take away this bhayankara duswapna. So, something is, you know, given in as upayas, Vaidika upayas. Japa pada prakshalana. Adi, there may be Adi Padena, there may be other, you know, some prayaschita karma ityadi. Aneka upayan anutishtati. Follows many upayas, not one or two. Any which way. I want this dusvapna to go any which way, nightmare. Otherwise, I don't want to go to sleep. In that state, something has to be done. Tatha, similarly, mithyabhutopi ayam samsaraha janmadi dukkha hetutvena me pratibhati. Even if this samsara is mithya like that swapna, still janmadi dukkha hetu leads to janma. Then all between janma and marana, every vikara is dukkha hetu. One way or the other. Little sukha, but then sandwiched with some sukha, lot of dukkha. Dukkha hetu tvena me pratibhati. Appears to me there is pratiti of dukkha. How can you? I mean, the shishya is tapping the grace. No, help me out. I have dukkha. And somehow this teaching has not worked right now. I want it to work. Show me a way out. Ataha tan nivartanam ichhami. Therefore, that samsara nivritti ichha, although you do not think it is na yujyate, na uchita, still aham ichhami. Aham tu ichhami eva. Because I have this dukkha which feels real, so real. I can't wish it away. So you help me out. Tasmat nivrutyupayam krupaya vada bhoho iti shishya prashnaha. So please, so prashna here is request. There is a request. Please, due to your compassion, see the dukkha that I feel and give me an upaya so that I don't feel this dukkha. I don't feel the weight of the dukkha. Guru Ruttaram, what is the answer the guru gives in the next 2 avartas? Atma jnana hetuka samsara nivrutyupayam. Tau atmajnanam eva upayaha. Says, do not lose sight of the teaching. Yes, there is dukkha. There is dukkha. There is dukkha. Pratiti is there because samsara pratiti is there. But you should hold on to the jnana. What is being taught is it is not real. If you keep on holding on to everything else in the samsara, and then you say dukkha should go away, it wouldn't go away. Viveka vairagya is the basis for atmajnana. Atmajnana will be flickery if vairagya and viveka driven vairagya is not strong enough for the shamadi shatka sampatti to be dridha. And if those are not dridha, then mumukshuttam will be itself will be wavering. It will not stay. I want moksha also. That also doesn't work. So if one is a moksha ichu, then a mumukshu should give up everything, pursuit of everything else. So samsara dukkha nivritti ichha no chita in its garbha also means that samsara pravritti is also mithya, no chita. The problem is holding on to the pravritti of the everything that is good. One wants to hold on, then one cannot wish away the samsara dukkha. So dukkha nivritti is possible by jnana only when the sukha pravritti also is dropped. Then it is hidden in the samsara dukkha nivritti, it is hidden, which is very easily lost sight of. That's why people do not think of samsara being an issue when there is happiness. That's why the pursuit is of happiness. However I get it, whether I get it through Vishaya Sukha, I don't care. I want that happiness. Right now, I want Sukha. But Dukkha, I do not want. It cannot be avoided. It comes as a parcel. So to avoid Dukkha, initially, even before this Jnana to work, why doesn't the Jnana work? Because it's like, you know, the monkey holding on to, holding on to the phala in the small necked pot. The neck of the pot is big enough for the hand to enter, but not big enough for the fist holding, the hand holding the fruit to come out. So what should the monkey do? Cannot cry that my hand is stuck. The pot has, you know, bitten onto my hand. That is a samsara dukkha nivritti. We hold on to it, but we want it to go away. It cannot go away because we are holding on to it. And that dropping of the fruit is like the jnana. What does the monkey need to know? The monkey needs to know that I am holding on to it, giving it up will free my hand. I am the one who is bound because of my own actions. So jnana alone will give him nivritti. So jnana is what? Jnana is, he does not have to do the karma. He has to give up the karma of holding. That is how it has to be looked into. So giving up, when one gives up, when one distances oneself from the earlier oneself, then alone this jnana will work. So atma ajnana hetuka samsara. One considers this prapancha as the source of happiness, that is the ajnana, because one considers oneself as limited entity who is wanting to become limitless, get sukha which is limitless by becoming someone or something else, by avoiding someone or something else. That is the atma ajnana, which becomes the hetu for samsara. So atma ajnana hetuka samsara nivruttam. For the nivritti of that kind of samsara, which has been caused by atma jnana, how will it go? For nivritti, what has to be done? Atma jnana meva upaya. Towards that atma ajnana hetuka samsara nivritti, atma jnana alone is the upaya. If you are looking for any other upaya, it won't work, says the guru to tattva drishti. He shishya jagadrupa dukhasya atyanta nivruttaye prushta upaya prageva nirupitaha. He says, I have already given you the upaya. Hold on to that upaya or inquire more into that upaya. What is the upaya? The upaya is atma jnana. Why? Because your problem is due to all your samsarika dukkha, samsara is due to atma jnana. Once you hold on to that atma jnana which has already been given, if you understand it, inquire, do manana and hold on to that, dukkha will fade away. Because it is apparent now because the atma is not apparent. Atma is still hidden. You are still considering yourself as the samsarika jiva. संसारी जीवा, नॉट संसारी के, संसारी जीवा, दैट संसार जीवा, संसारी जीवा हैज दुख. आई एम आस्किंग यू टू बी द रियल आत्मा, जीवात्मा हु इज साक्षी, हु इज चैतन्य रूप, हु हैज नो दुख बिकॉज ही हैज नो संसार. सो यू हैव टू शिफ्ट, इट्स अ कॉग्निटिव शिफ्ट, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन ओवरनाइट. सो इट टेक्स टाइम. You'll understand what has been taught. So, upayaha, prishta upaya, prageva nirupita. Shraddha bhakti purasaram tatra dhrida nishchaya kriyatam. So, what you should do is, you hold on to that firmly. You have not understood the teaching otherwise. If you understand the teaching, you would not give it up. You would not think about the earlier issues, because earlier issues will go away by the already given solution. So there has to be Shraddha in that solution, which unfortunately is lacking for most of us. At the back of the mind, there is a question, can it be true? So Samshaya, that Samshaya will not lead to Dhrida Jnana, it will not lead to Jnana itself, let alone Dhrida Jnana. And Bhakti should be there, that Shruti and Guru wants my welfare. So, Shraddha in the Shruti and Guru, Bhakti also should be there, which should finally land on Atma Bhakti. It should not be Vishaya Bhakti. It should not be Bhinna Devata Bhakti. Slowly, starting there, it should land on Atma Bhakti. And this should precede what? Purasaram. Purasaram is, it should precede the firm conviction that I am Brahma. Therefore, he says, Shraddha Bhakti Purasaram Tatra Dhadarashche Kriyatam Tatra Kutra Upaye Tasmin Upaye Tasmin Ne Upaye Yah Prag Prageva Nirupitaha Tasmin Upaye Dhadarashcheha Kriyatam Tataha Jagadrupa Dukham Anumatram api Twai na drishyeta. And then when you cognitively shift, then you are no longer looking at Jagat as a separate entity, then Dukkha will not be there. Anumatram api Twai na drishyeta, you will not cognize it. Because Atma drishti, if you have, you cannot have Samsara drishti together. Either you have Samsara drishti, whereby there will be Dukkha, or you have Atma Drishti even while having Samsara Drishti. While looking outward also you can have Atma Drishti. That is Sarvatma Bhava. And then Toyi Anumatram Api Jagadrupam Dukkham Nadrishyeta He Somya Advitiya Asanga Chinmatra Rupa Swatma Swarupasya Aparijnanad Jagadrupa Dukkham Tava Pratibhati. So what is the cause for this Dukkha Pratibhana? Dukkha Pratiti. Jagad Rupa Dukkha Pratiti is there for you. Why? Because Advitiya Asanga Chinmatra Rupa Swatma Swarupasya Aparijnana. Due to this, Aparijnanat. So, due to Aparijnana. Not having complete Jnana. There is, when you say, here he made a statement. No, I understand, I and earlier. So, anyway, so he made a statement as, anyway, since I mentioned it. So he says, Jagat Twai Mithyayava Swapnadivat Pratibhati Nacha Asti Tat Paramartha Sadrupane Iti Yaduktam Tat Satyameva. This is, although he agrees what you said is real, I don't feel it. So Shraddha Bhakti is lacking, I don't feel it. Some Manana is lacking. Therefore Shraddha Bhakti Purasaram and Prageva Nirupita Upaya, that alone will work. And then Tavak Kimartham Pratibhati, Samsara Dukkham, Jagadrupa Samsara. What is Jagadrupa Dukkha? Why? Because Tava Atma Swarupa Parijnana Advitiya Asanga Chinmatra. Your Swarupa is Advitiya Asanga. You are not attached to anything in the Jagat. So the Jagad Dukkha is also away from you. It is not there in you. You are Chinmatra Rupa and Swatma Swarupa is in this manner. You do not know that. Whatever you know is little. It is not parijnana, it is aparijnana. Because when you say, you know, I understand what you are saying is right, but still, when that but still comes in, then paritajnana is not there. Therefore, aparijnana jagadrupa dukkham tava pratibhati. Tachya tava atmasvarupa parijnana matran nivarteta. How will it go away? Just by complete jnana. Just bridge that gap. Whatever gaps you have in jnana, you just need to fill it. Oh, jnana is not working. Jnana is not working because jnana is not there, sir. Parita jnana is not there. So it, one tries another upaya, yet another upaya. No, none other upaya will work because there is no other upaya. They are not upayas at all. So what will work? Same jnana which has been taught. No, it is too repetitive. Oh, it is repetitive because it has to be repeated because I have not understood. I have understood, but not completely. So, you know, oh, I think I get it, you move on. But if you inquire into it, has it brought about a change in me that reflects you me? If I continue to be the same way, I hanker after the same things, I try to run away from the same things, and I think I have the satyatva buddhi in each and everything that is mithya, like earlier, then it won't work. That is the reason it isn't working. In fact, we cannot say that, we cannot think that the result should go in, you know, the result. We can't look for the result while holding on to it the way it was earlier. That's why the monkey example. So, tava atma swarupa parijnana matra. That if the jnana is not paripurna, one has to give, at the cost of everything, one has to go after jnana. You put in everything that you have to get this jnana. Therefore, yadvastu yasya jnanat bhati, tadvastu tasya jnanat nivartate iti niyamaha. Therefore, using this niyama, what you need to do is hold on to the same nirupita upaya and continue that. The whenever it becomes parijnana, jnana becomes parijnana or aparijnana becomes parijnana, that time this dukkha nivrutti will be there. Jagadrupa dukkham tava na pratibhasate tada. You yourself will make that claim. Yad vastu yasya jnanad bhati, tad vastu tasya jnanad eva nivartata. The eva kara can be added. It will not go away by any other jnana. It will not go away by anything other than jnana. So it will go by that vastu jnana itself, which the ajnana regarding which has brought about some effect, you know. So rajva jnana sarpa pratibhasate. So bhati, how will it go away? Tadvastu tasya jnana nivartate iti niyamaha. So rajva jnana deva sarpa nivritti, rajva jnana pratiyamana sarpaha rajureva iyam iti rajju jnana matrad yatha nivartate tatha atma jnana pratiyamanam jagat api atma tattva sakshatkara matrena nivartate eva matrena. So only atma tattva sakshatkara will take away the samsara, which is jagat. This jagat appears because of atma jnana, therefore it will go away only by atma tattva sakshatkara. Atma jnana sakshatkara dhradataya, sakshatkara is aparoksha jnana. So paripurna jnana or parijnana is all aparoksha jnana or sakshatkara or anubhuti or anubhava, whatever you call it, it is manana siddha with nishtha. Tachya atma tattva jnanam upadishta purvam api bhuyaha anubhyakhyasyami. So it has already been taught, but still again I'll teach you because it has lost on you. Not completely understood. Therefore, that atma tattva jnana which has been taught earlier, same thing I'll teach again with a, you know, slight twist there. Kalatrayapi mai jagat anumatram api nasti mithyatva swapnavat. So he gives tarka now. Tarka is kalatrayapi mai जगदणु मात्र अभी नास्ती, देर इज नॉट इवन अ बिट ऑफ संसार प्रपंच इन मी. वाय? मिथ्यात्वात्. इट इज नॉट सत्य, इट इज मिथ्या. संसार इज मिथ्या. हाउ? स्वप्नवत. स्वप्नवत मिथ्यात्वात् मयि जगत अणुमात्रमपि नास्ति. दैट इज दी व्याप्ति ज्ञान. देन यन मिथ्या तद अधिष्ठानम न दुष्येत, दूषयेत, सॉरी, यन मिथ्या तद अधिष्ठानम न दूषयेत. यू आर दी अधिष्ठान एंड आधार ऑफ दिस मिथ्या रूप संसार, एंड वॉट एवर इज मिथ्या, द नियम इज इट के नॉट टेंट और अफेक्ट दी अधिष्ठान. मिराज वॉटर डज नॉट वेट दी the desert sand. Similarly, this mithya samsara cannot affect you at all. There is a pratiti, all right, but it cannot affect you. You cannot be dukhi. Samsara is dukkha rupa, all right, but you cannot be dukhi on account of that, because you are the adharan adhisthana for that dukkha rupa samsara also. It is mithya kalpita. Nahi marichyudakam, nahi marichyudakam usharad desham ma. देशम आद्री करोति. दी मिराज वाटर डज नॉट वेट दी ऊषर भूमि, दी डेजर्ट सैंड और लैंड. तथा मयि प्रतीयमानम अपि इदम जगत मिथ्यात्वात् न मे कामपि हानिं कर्तुं प्रवति. सिमिलरली इट के नॉट अफेक्ट मी एट ऑल, इट के नॉट हर्ट मी. दिस दुख के नॉट रियली हर्ट मी, बिकॉज इट इज ओनली प्रतीयमानम. इवन इफ इट इज सीन, it is only seen, it is not real, it is kalpita. Mithyatvat name kam api hanim kartum prabhavati. Aham sachidananda ananta advitiya asanga brahma swarupah eva asmi. Why? I am in reality what? Sachidananda, sat chit and ananda, ananta. So satyam jnanam anantam brahma, that ananta, and sachidananda, that therefore sachid ananda also, that is my swarupa. I am advitiya, there is no second me, which me not with the body mind sense complex, one without the body mind sense complex. That sachidananda tattva cannot be proven to be another. There is no another sachidananda, there is no proof for that. Advitiya asanga, who is unattached to anything else, because advitiya, anything that is there, it has to be kalpita. It cannot be real. So where is sangha possible? There is no sangha possible. I am asanga. That Brahma is me. Brahma swarupa eva asmi. Iti evam nischaya eva jnanam ityuchyate. Nischaya jnanam. Nischaya jnanam ityuchyate. Not that, okay, what you say is right. Tattva drishti says, yes, what you said is true. What you said is right, but I don't feel it is not jnana. Nishchaya, what you say is right, it cannot be any other way. There is no possibility, any other possibility. Pratiti, possibility also should be taken away. How pratiti is real should be taken away. So nishchaya eva jnanam. This nishchaya is lacking. Therefore, it is not parijnanam, it is jnanam, but jnanam figuratively, because it is paroksha jnana. What you say is right, what Shruti says is right. I don't have manana siddha jnana. That is not going to help me. I do not want Jagat to get moksha. I don't want Guru to get moksha. I already assume he has got it. My swartha is my moksha. Then what Guru says, you know, just, you know, stamping, putting a rubber stamp over my, what my Guru teaches is absolutely great. Helpless. I am helpless. It just making that statement, if I continue to remain helpless, how is it helping me? My Guru may be the best. I may have the best resources, but still I continue to have this dukkha. My swartha is my dukkha nivritti. Thereby jnanam should not be paroksha. It should be aparoksha. It should be immediate, not mediate. My Guru says it. Upanishad quotation I can make. I can make a Gita kantastha. It is kantastha to me. Does not help me, unfortunately. Nishchaya isn't there. So the study should not necessarily be vast. Vastness is good. Panditya is good. But what is important there is, good to have is not what is mandatory. What is mandatory is nishchaya. It can happen with one Vedanta Sara, Paribhasha, Tattva Bodha, anything, Mahavakya, ఈవెన్ మహాభారత కథ, ఎనీ యునో మోక్ష ధర్మ శాస్త్ర, ఎనీథింగ్, బట్ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి నిశ్చయ, డౌట్లెస్ నాలెడ్జ్, దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ విల్ వర్క్. ఇది ఏవం నిశ్చయ ఏవ జ్ఞానమిత్యుచ్యతే, ఏతదేవ జ్ఞానం ఆసుప్తే రామృతేశ్చ నిరంతరం అభ్యస్యమానం మోక్ష సాధనం. ఐ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ టైమ్ ఫర్ ఆల్ దిస్. 1 hour sometimes across, maybe one day also, every day 1 hour, not sufficient. Because nischaya, if it is there, then oh, what else should I do? That should be the question. What other things am I doing? Is it so? Nischaya should lead to jnana, which is nischaya rupa jnana of aham brahmasmi. It should lead to the question, is every indulgence of mine, every activity of mine, which need not necessarily be only kayika, kayika, manasika, vachika, is it tuned towards that jnana? If it isn't, then it is not parijnana. With the earlier same buddhi, if I am continuing with what is happening, that's why I said that in the jagat dukkha nivritti, there is a sukha pravritti nivritti also there. This pravritti should also go away. But that continues, and I just want to avoid dukkha, it doesn't work. Therefore, eta deva jnanam, this jnana, what should be the commitment to this jnana? Asuptehe amrutehe cha. As long as one does not fall asleep, not that, okay, time to sleep, let me go to sleep. Yes, you go to sleep, you know, I'll retire to bed, but still my buddhi should be in this jnana. Throughout the day, at the cost of everything else, that is the idea here. So we should gradually, I mean, it cannot happen overnight. Gradually, it should lead to that. Asupte amrutescha. And how long should I do it? Why do you care how long? This kala is mithya. So as long as the body is there, as long as you can do it, you should continue. So I should continue holding on to this jnana, asuptehe, until I fall asleep. And until this body does not fall off, amruteshcha nirantaram. How can I do anything else? There is nothing else to do. That is why moksha eka iccha. If how can I do anything else? This question itself shows the failure in what? In పురుషార్థ నిశ్చయ, ధర్మ అర్థ కామ మోక్ష. అదర్ దెన్ మోక్ష, వాట్ ఎల్స్ ఇస్ దేర్? ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఎల్స్ ఈస్ అ ఫెయిలియర్ ఇన్ మోక్ష పురుషార్థ, యాజ్ ది ఏకమేవ ఏకహేవ పురుషార్థ. దేర్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ పురుషార్థ రియలీ, విచ్ ఈస్ పురుషార్థ నిశ్చయ, దట్ మోక్ష ఈస్ ది పురుషార్థ. బీయింగ్ బోర్న్ యాజ్ అ పురుష, యాజ్ అ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్, my goal has to be only moksha, because artha and kama is there for every prani. Who has dharma? Dharma is additional to me, but they have samanya dharma, others also have some samanya dharma. They follow through instincts also, it is there embedded, some samanya dharma is there. But specifically, what is this dharma shastra? Dharma shastra is for good living, to avoid dukkha and gain sukha. But dharma shastra is also tuned towards what? Finally to Vedanta. So that from dharma you make a jump, skipping artha and outgrowing artha and kama, and land on moksha, whereby there is purushartha nischaya, moksha alone is the goal. Then where is the question of anything else to be done? So nirantaram is appropriate. That is why, see, Tattva Drishti didn't ask, how do I continue with this loka palana? My father has left one loka at least for me. He was a triloka palaka and trilokya palaka, and then he left one loka each to be looked after for each of the three children. I have a responsibility, how do I take? He didn't think of that because of wanting moksha. He is a mumukshu. Not mumukshu in the sense of just, the yogic artha of moksha ichchu. Moksha ichchu, but only moksha ichchu. That's why, Bhashyakara. Who is a Bhashyakara? Bhashyakara is नॉट भाष्यम करोति इति भाष्यकार, इट इज अ ताच्छील्य प्रत्यय, भाष्यं करोति ताच्छील्येन तच्छीलः, यू नो कंपोजिंग कॉमेंट्रीज भाष्यास इज हिज ओनली जॉब देयर प्राइमरीली, अदर्स आर यू नो जस्ट यू नो कीपिंग द बॉडी अलाइव टिकिंग, बट दैट इज द भाष्यकार. सिमिलरली मुमुक्षु इज व्हाट मोक्षम एव इच्छु वन हू, सो एवकार शुड बी देयर, इट शुड तच्छील, इट शुड बी टेकन एज ताच्छील्य अर्थे, देन ओनली इट विल वर्क, देयरफॉर निरंतरम अभ्यस्यमानं मोक्ष साधनम. सो वी शुड ऑल इंक्वायर इनटू इट, इट्स नॉट वर्किंग, इफ इट इज नॉट वर्किंग, सिंपल रीजन आमृतेहे आसुक्तेहे इज वी आर नॉट इवन क्लोज टू दिस. अनफॉर्चुनेटली circumstances, whatever we say, you know, we can think of thousands of reasons, all may be valid also, I don't know, because I mean it is not you or anyone else, we come across this thought, each one of us comes across this thought as somehow it is not working yet, but we should know yet, why, because my efforts are not sufficient, my samsara satyatva buddhi has not gone, sukha in the samsara is still there. Therefore, dukkha will be there. Asupte amrutescha nirantaram abhyasyamanam moksha sadhanam. That is moksha sadhanam in bold. Jnana, jnanam eva moksha sadhanam. What kind of jnana should be there? Parijnana. What is that parijnana? Nishchaya. What is the nishchaya? Eva asmi. What eva? Satchidananda ananta advitiya asanga brahma swarupa eva asmi. How will it happen? By jnana, paripurna jnana. This is a jnana. What is a sadhana? Moksha sadhana. Eta deva jnanam asukte amrutescha nirantaram abhyasyama. Nirantaram abhyasyamanam. So we should all, you know, progress towards that goal. Na anyat kinchidapi. Na anyat kinchidapi moksha sadhanam bhavati. So if we think of, no, you tell me some, no other upaya can be told. Everything else is a concession. Try it out. Come back when the time is appropriate, when the mind is more refined. Tadidam jnanam purvameva upadishtavan asmi iti guru raha. I have already taught you. There is no, and especially the guru does not want tattva drishti to slip. He knows the capacity of tattva drishti. If he continues this, he is unlike the others, which we'll see later. He can hold on to it. And if he holds on to it, he has Shraddha, then he'll not miss it. Jnanam eva ajnana nashikam na karma upasanadi. If one thinks, no, you give me a karma or upasana, that will not take away ajnana. It will facilitate chitta shuddhi, which will make jnana possible. So if the person has not done karma upasana, then holding on to this nirantara is not possible. So karma upasana are needed. Why? So that one can have viveka driven vairagya. Then alone jnana will take place. If one does not have it and one gets this jnana, that jnana is not going to be still, because karma upasana are pending, which will not let the jnana to be stable. That's the idea. But so we have to see this further. It will come up. But right now, jnanam eva ajnana nashakam na karma upasanadi. We'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part. Sukhan nityam saprakasham vyapakan namurupe adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatnu nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vidyam pratyak param maha tadeva ahannamattu anyat iti menishchita matihi. Any questions? Okay, I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Namaste. Hari Om.